story of Alan Adale. I really like this one because I really like Alan Adale. I think he kind of stands out from the rest of the Merry Men as being quite a different character. He's very much a lover, not a fighter. Stories in the Greenwood usually begin in the mornings. And it was one fine morning. Robin was walking through the Greenwood, wondering what the day would bring. And what the day brought to him was a strangely dressed young man, not wearing green or brown, like someone who would usually spend time in the forest, but wearing surprisingly bright but well-mended clothes. And on his back, he carried a harp. And he looked a picture of misery. And Robin, who's, you know, Robin's a kind person. Robin approached him and asked why he looked so mournful. And the young man looked at Robin and said, "My name is Alan. I am known as Alan Adale. I am a musician. I play my harp. I tell stories. I sing songs. It is my life. For the rest of my life is my beloved. Without her, I know I can never be truly happy. And today, she will wed another man." Robin listened until Alan told him the whole story. Alan, the musician. And of course, then, as now, it's not a proper job, is it? So, Alan had fallen in love with a woman somewhat above his station. Her father had promised her hand to a man who was wealthy, a much better connection for the family, that he was much, much older, and of course was an arranged marriage. And Alan's sweetheart had her heart set on marrying the impoverished musician, not the wealthy man, old enough to be her father. "Tomorrow the wedding will take place, and I know which church." Robin took Alan to the outlaw camp, and there he sang, and he tells stories. Alan Adale very often tells stories from the court of King Arthur. He sang and he tells stories, and the outlaws thought they had never heard someone who could harp a tune so well. They had never heard someone who could sing so well. They had never had a better evening in the Greenwood than that one evening when Alan Adale was there to tell stories, to sing songs, and to play his harp. The next day was the day when Alan's sweetheart was going to marry the rich but old man. The outlaw band travelled to the church with Friar Tuck. And Friar Tuck had a long cloak over his friar's kirtle, his friar's, what do you call it, gown, I suppose, the dress sort of thing friars were. Apparently it's technically known as a kirtle. Robin was in disguise and carrying Alan's harp. The outlaws wore disguise with long cloaks under which they had bows hidden. The bride was waiting at the altar. There was a bishop going to marry them. And the bishop was wearing a long, heavy gold chain. So when I got to the part of the service where the bishop asked, does anyone know any just reason why these two people may not marry? Friar Tuck stepped forward from a pew, threw off his cloak and said, I know of a just reason. The bride does not love the groom. And it was at that moment that the doors opened and the outlaw band of the Merry Men ran into the church. And Robin himself relieved the bishop of the burden of the heavy gold chain that he wore around his neck. The outlaws removed the bridegroom and the father. And Alan took the place of the bridegroom at the altar. And Friar Tuck joined Alan a Dale to his true love in holy matrimony. A state from which, of course, once you have made those vows, you cannot be released. So, Robin and the Merry Men gained some gold from the bishop. Friar Tuck achieved justice. And, as a man of God, joined two lovers together. Alan a Dale married his sweetheart. And we hope that they lived, this is your line, you get to do this. Are you ready? Happily, come on, happily ever after. So all, of course, ended well. There are some stories where Alan a Dale then joins the Merry Men. That would mean that his wife would also have to join the Merry Men. But I think the point of Marion's character is that she is the only woman in the Greenwood. It's more likely, actually, that as a musician that he would wander off. Probably work as a spy for someone, actually. I think of all the Robin Hood stories, that is probably my favourite, really. And I think Alan is definitely my favourite character. If you'd like to hear some other Robin Hood stories, please subscribe to my channel and check out the Robin Hood's Merry Men Facebook group and listen again. And I do hope to see you soon. Harp would, of course, have been a bard's instrument, a minstrel's instrument. And we still use the phrase to keep harping on about that, which I think is probably a reference to the fact that some of the stories that storytellers told at that time were too long. So I will bid you all a fond farewell and see you again soon.